Hi, and welcome to Data Stream Development with Apache Spark, Kafka, and Spring Boot. At the end of this course, you will have the complete package of skills needed for architecting and implementing an end-to-end data streaming pipeline. But before we begin, allow me to introduce myself. So, my name is Angel Leonard, I'm a Java Chief Architect, and I have more than 20 years of experience in IT industry. As you may expect it, I'm a big fan of big data as well. Okay, enough about me, let's not waste too much time here, because we have a long and wonderful journey ahead. Okay, so let's set up the course agenda, or course overview. At the end of this video, you should have a clear picture of what is the main goal of this course, how we will approach it further, and what are the final expectations or benefits. So, our journey requires us to go through 6 stages or sections. Section 1, Introducing Data Streaming Blueprint Architecture, has several key points. First, we will shape the big picture of what is data streaming. Once we have set up the landscape, we can bring into play the blueprint architecture via a meaningful diagram. This diagram will become our best mate during this course. Now, having a cool architecture in place opens the road ahead for choosing a data source for our streaming pipeline and the technologies to implement it. There is no secret that we will use the Meetup RSVP livestream, and our streaming pipeline will rely on Apache Kafka, Spark, Spring Boot, and MongoDB. Section 2, Deployment of Collection and Message Queuing Tiers, is just a big and juicy source of information. For start, in the streaming context, we will discuss about the interaction patterns and protocols used for ingesting a data stream. Next, we will have a dedicated video for discovering the role played by the message queuing tier in our architecture. Further, we take some action, and we will use Spring WebSocket API to collect data from the Meetup RSVP endpoint and Spring Cloud Stream to send the collected data into an Apache Kafka topic. Section 3, Proceeding to the Data Access Tier, is dedicated to read and write operations against the output of a streaming analysis process. From the writing perspective, we will cover different storage options, from long-term storages to in-memory storages, and we will see which one is the proper choice depending on the writing type. Writing on stream speed, writing in batches, or using a batch loader. Of course, we will cover caching strategies as well. Now, reading from a storage that is continuously and endlessly filled by a streaming process is not a walk in the park. This is why one of the key aspects of this section will focus on Spring Reactive, and you will see how to expose such a storage, MongoDB in this case, in a reactive manner. We will also drop an eye on static and dynamic filtering topic. In section 4, Implementing the Analysis Tier, we reach the climax of our dissertation. So far, we know how to collect, store, and query data, and it is time to learn how to analyze it. In other words, we learn how to exploit data in our benefit. I'm straightforward, and I tell you that we will use Apache Spark. We will discover Spark Streaming, Spark SQL, Structured Streaming, and Spark Machine Learning. And we will develop applications for each of the discussed topic. When you will touch this section, there will be no surprise for you to see that this is just another comprehensive source of information. Let me give you a flavor. You don't know what is the mighty machine learning? Well, believe me, you will. You don't know what other choices we have beside Apache Spark and how to decide what to use? Well, you will find out for sure. Well, at this point, we are quite good in the streaming field. We have covered a lot of topics. We know a lot of tips and tweaks, and we have developed an end-to-end streaming pipeline. We start to think about scaling, security, and preventing losing data. Well, Section 5 contains a dissertation about preventing losing data between the collection and message queuing tiers. More exactly, we will talk about the hybrid message logging technique and its flavors. But we don't stop here, because we will introduce the Kafka Connect framework as well, especially the Debezium connector for MongoDB. Now, technically speaking, you don't need anything special for this course. I will use Java 8, Windows as the operating system, but it can be any other operating system, and NetBeans, but you can rely on any other IDE that you like.